Hey everyone, Gabriel Nassif for ChannelFireball.com and Ultimate Guard, and today I'm going to be playing some Modern. I'm going to be straight up net decking the list that won one of the two Modern challenges this weekend. It's a Bring to Light Scape Shift list that also uses a Elvish Reclaimer and Dryad, so a cross between Titan decks, but without Titan, and with Bring to Light and Scape Shift as a top end, and you obviously get to Bring to Light for Tibalt, which is a huge deal. And this deck looks good to me, pretty streamlined. Bolt, Remand, Teferi, Time Unraveler are just cards that are going to be good in pretty much every matchup. We've got a couple of Cleansing Wildfires to go with your Flex Zone of Trocares. Also, obviously decent if you ever get paired against Tron. And the one Verdict you can get was Bring to Light. Verdict's just a pretty solid card, right? You have your own creature, so kind of interesting to see if you actually need that card in your deck or not. The sideboard has a bit of hate card, a bit of anti-hate card. You've got Planemon and Madcap package. You've got Blessing for the mill decks, I'm assuming. Rip Apart for, not too sure, more removal? I'm not super familiar with Scape Shift decks, so I'm not sure which artifacts or enchantment you're really worried about. Maybe a card you bring in a mirror match to kill other people's Dryads. You've got a couple Onward Egos for combo decks. Veils, Vanishing Verse. Not exactly sure what each card's purpose is. I'm also not sure what Sigarda is for. I'm assuming it's the passive. Spells and abilities your opponents can't cause you to sacrifice Ferment, so maybe I'll come up and it'll be obvious once we get the matchup where it's supposed to be good. But yeah. List looks sweet and good. I didn't take a good look at the mana base. I'm assuming it's pretty reasonable. So yeah, let's give it a try. Might have a few voice issues. I'll try to be careful. Voice froze been bothering me since yesterday. I think it was maybe acid reflux, or not too sure. Maybe allergies. I'm not really allergic to stuff in general, but maybe the pollen count's just super, super high right now, so might be bothering me. But yeah, I'll try to be careful and bear with me if there's all coughing or throat noises. Well, telephone marketer, just let it ring. Obviously pretty decent hand. We've got Turn On Reclaimer into Flax Zone of Choker, so that's kind of the dream for this deck. Got Dryad to ramp really fast. Close that for now. I played a couple leagues of Modern yesterday. I've mostly been playing Historic this week on Arena. I played a couple leagues with Mono Blue Control. I was tempted by the Oryx, see if that card could be good and make a difference. That card was not especially good, and I went straight up 0-3 drop, 0-2 drop with the deck, so did not work out very well. All right, looks like we're in a really good spot against turn one Giver of Runes here. I guess they might have the Hate Bears and whatnot. No Arbiter. Is Stoneforge something we need to be worried about? Not too sure. Any specific land I should be getting? I'm assuming I should just be getting... I guess it's kind of tricky. Sword of Feast and Famine. If they can get rid of my Valakut, I don't have that much going on. I guess I should just be getting another Flagstone, right? For now. Red Triome. In case we naturally ramp to six mountains. And then I'm assuming a Flagstone's the best I can do right now. If we draw a non-tap land, we might be able to trigger Dryad right away. We'll see. I was a tiny bit surprised not to see a single copy of Renin 6 in the list, but I guess you maybe don't need it. Maybe a bit slow and hard to cast on turn 2. Alright, cleansing. So I could get a Flagstone and then cleansing it and ramp a decent bit. That seems good. If I'd drawn a non-tap land, I could have done cool stuff, I think. Alright, let's see. So maybe do that. Get Rogue and Triumph again. Get Flagstone again. Go ahead and fetch basic, I guess. Basic forest. I don't want to get Stomping Ground. I'm getting close to natural Valakut. And about 17 still. How sorry. All right, I guess I'll pay the life. Honestly, not sure if this is necessary or not. Mountain. I'm not sure I have a red tri- I have a Rogan Triumph left, right? Probably have a Sacred Foundry left as well. No, just Sacred Foundry. Oh, I drew Lightning Bolt. Nice. Well, insurance. Alright, pretty much just cruising this game. PV's new card. Paulo Vitor Damo da Rosa, World Champion. Doesn't do much here. Not much at all. Ooh, the match. All right. Maybe my opponent was already 0-2 or something and they were kind of out their deck. Maybe that to run. Maybe it's an atrocious matchup. Modern meta has looked still fairly diverse. If you go through the deck's doing well, it's still a decent bit of Heliod and Prowse decks. But you've got some brews, you've got this deck. I saw a male deck with Storm Herald and Eldrazi Conscription make top 8 in one of the challenges. You've got some Taxes deck. All right, this hand's not as good. Seven cards for them. So what am I hoping for here? I've got a Bolt, I've got turn three Dryad. At least I can draw a lot of cards. I do have 31 lands in my deck. I'm assuming I'm supposed to keep. Because I don't think these decks necessarily mulligan very well. Arbor Elf. Okay. Definitely gonna get rid of that right away. Do I have a choice? Stomping Ground? I do have Steam Vein actually. Assuming it's Stomping Ground I want. Alright, they would have had a lot of mana. Oh, they're playing the red version. Yikes. I don't know if I was hoping for a company or... I guess that's what Trip Apart gets, right? Blood Moon. Alright, I'm gonna play my fetch land in case I get Blood Mooned. So do I want to play Flaxon? Does that make sense? I don't think playing Flaxon does a ton for me. Are they just super flooded? Did they just keep like turbo mana hand with nothing to do? Maybe a couple bolts? Okay, Ensnaring Bridge. Well, that's not very scary. Looks like we might be up against a brew. Alright, a little ramp. It's a good target there, lands. Probably targeting mines better. Oh, I drew Scape Shift. I've already played on land, right? Oh no, I haven't. All right. Sag them all? Probably. I guess I'll go for the kill. To target one by one and save targets. All right, so I got two Valakuts, so I had to kill this turn. I had a bunch of mountains and fetches in case something went wrong and they had a removal for my giant. Can I do always yes? Always yes. And always yield. Alright, red green lock. I'm assuming they're gonna have Blood Moon. Would I ever want Madcap against them? How did they kill me? They're gonna kill me with Planeswalkers, right? I'm guessing they're gonna have an answer to Platinum. Vanishing Verse also gets Friends of a Blood Moon. Verdict seems like it might not be great. Can maybe trim Escape Shift in these matchups against decks that don't have discard spells or maybe just trim the Bring to Light. Vanishing Verse kind of hard to cast now. Doesn't get rid of a Karn, which I'm assuming they're playing. I guess I'm going to do all the cheap removal. From some of the top end. Is that trimming too much top end? I feel like I only need to draw one of these three cards once I'm set up. Huh. No green mana. They're mulliganing. Right, I'm going to take a mulligan as well, I guess. Much better. I'll just bottom dry it, I think. Keep all my lands. Alright, let's lead was... I don't want to get basic planes for Blood Moon Insurance. Yeah, I should have just played Temple Garden so I can potentially cast Rip Apart next turn. Yeah. That was like a bit convoluted to play Overgrown Tomb first. I'm going to play that first so I can fetch basic plants if I need to. Do I kill it now? Probably. Well, I can take advantage of Blood Moon first. If I kill it now, I could cycle first, but then if they have something for my one basic plans, I'm kind of screwed. Bloodbraid, Karn, Chandra, Karn, yeah. Yeah. Rough spots. In hindsight, keeping that dried would have been good. You have so many lands you're supposed to keep dried there. I'll try to get out of this lock really easily. Rip apart, I guess. Monocolored permanent. Nice. Thanks. I was gonna use my remand just to cantrip. So that Vanishing Verse could have been nothing super good, right? Mostly Scape Shift or 5 mana cards. They're kind of going up to the wrong lands. All right, maybe I'll get greedy. And minus Karn. Doesn't seem reasonable, but you never know. Yeah. I had a lot of problems. Need to draw a bolt for a car, and then need to draw a rip apart for a blood moon. Yes, I kind of have the answer to. Yeah, a vanishing verse. Huh. What do I even bounce? Just plus, I guess. This seems to be like a tough matchup, tougher than round one. They have a few annoying cards. But yeah, if I'd kept that Dryad in hindsight, I would have probably won. 31 lands in the deck, maybe you just keep the Dryad and you know you're gonna draw lands. Two for body would have been very relevant, just pressure Karn. White. Are they trolling? What's up with all the white mana? They're really making me regret not scooping. This is torture. Probably 0% to win, right? Maybe an 8-8? Surely they board out most of their bridges. Just a huge body. It's also a card I can cast easily, even against Blood Moon. I think I want to keep in bold because of Karn minus and the elves. Vanishing Verse. I think Vanishing Verse is just too hard to cast, honestly. And then maybe I want all the Bring to Light, just because Bring to Light to Vault is really strong against them. And not that hard to get. Yeah, just one do bolt on the play. Maybe Teferi's medium. Teferi's probably not that great. It's like kind of hard to cast against Blood Moon. It's nice to have him play before Blood Moon, but Well, I do have a bolt and a remand. I am playing 31 lands, so I'm assuming I should keep. Oh. It's pretty great for me. Feels like they've almost mulliganed to 5. Ripabard is your answer to one of your answers to Blood Moon's kind of sketchy though, sorcery speed. Meaning if you don't have basic planes in play, you just can't cast it. Blood Moon isn't super, super popular in Modern right now though. Clothless. I think I should just use my Remand no matter what. I mean, it does literally nothing right now. I'll let them have it and save my Remand. I usually like, you know, you're usually gonna use Remand on pretty much any spell, but this specific case, I feel like maybe I don't have to. So I could shock to be able to cast Remand. The thing is, I'm not sure if I want to get basic force or basic island yet. So if I shock here, I don't have to pick right away. Let's see, basic force casts Dryad, basic island casts Remand. I don't think a life toll is going to be super, super relevant here. I'll just shock, I guess. If you think about it, it doubles the chance of me drawing basic force or island, not fetching right away. Still pretty low chance, but something. I also just want to bolt and remand in the same turn. Oh, that's why they were naming white on the sprawls, to be able to hardcast Leyline. Karn. Alright, this I should probably remand. Alright, it's a good draw. The problem is, so how does it work? I think if you play it after Blood Moon, is it the layers? The layers rule was the Dryad? I think it might be. There's a chance I'm not supposed to play it right away. But I guess I will. Yeah, I'd feel so good if this was instant speed removal for a Blood Moon. A Celestial Purge, Disenchant, Aether Gust. Alright, as long as it's just Karn, I think we're in good shape. I think my plan is just to get Valky. Isn't they tapped out and I draw land? I can get Scapeshift and just kill them. Never mind that Blade Line in play, right? Coding, yes, okay. Baldacarn on tap. And now we have decisions. You have hexproof. What are my options? Escape ship doesn't do much. Madcap for thingy. Yeah, I'm assuming it's just gotta be Valky. Or Tybalt in that case. Tybalt plus. Man, it would have been nice. I'll just say go in case. What am I worried about? Bloodbraid Elf? I mean, Bloodbraid Elf plus a permanent turns on Clothis. So that'd be exactly 7 damage for my Tybalt. That'd be bad. Obviously, I haven't seen Bloodbraid Elf yet, and they had Instant Umbrage in their main deck, so they might not have it. But better said than sorry. Sorry. So what do I get with the next Bring to Light? Maybe just a Nomnath? Let's start with a plus here. Do you have Rip Apart for one of the ley lines? Could just dump my hand. I just bring to light for Omnath sounds really good. Surely that will win me the game. Could use Scape Ship just to be able to kill Shianras and whatnot, but I like the Omnath line, I think. Alright, glad I brought back in all these Bring to Lights. That was maybe a tiny bit loose. Board so many out. Play a land, gain 4. Fetch. Just get basic island, I guess. Could keep Freeman up, or I could dump my hand. I could rip apart Chandra as well. Too bad I can't play a land here. How much mana? Yeah, I'm just gonna chill, I think. Just play a Reclaimer. Next turn, I guess I can replay Graveyards next turn. Is that lazy, just killing one of the ley lines? Feels a tiny bit lazy. -8, exile old graveyard at 3 mana, and then I can play Alright, Clothless. Alright, do I have artifacts in my graveyard, in my sideboard? I can get with cloth that I can get with Karin now. Alright, let's see. Do that. Sack of Flagstone. So I'm gonna get two more trigger for Omnath. Get basic planes, I guess. And then maybe get a fetch land. So I can cycle in response. All right. We could just get a Valakut, I guess. Get the trigger, damage the planeswalkers. Oh, let's use my green mana. Oops. Because it's Sibalt, so you can use any colored mana, but I use my green. That's not what I want to do. Okay, I guess I'm not playing another Reclaimer. Oh no, never mind, I'm dumb. I have Arbor Elf. I like to check chat, just making sure I'm not being rude. All right, well, kind of tough matchup, but we dodged the nuts. This rip apart, kind of sketch. Sorcery speed is not my favorite, that's for sure. Yeah, off to a good start. Ooh, we got a queue right away. Of course, if you like the content, make sure you subscribe to the channel. If you want to see more, you can also give this video a like. You can also check out channelfireball.com for more content. If you want to check out articles and deck guides, there's also CFB Pro, which is the premium part of the website, and it has amazing content, super in-depth articles, deck guides, sideboard guides, matchup guides, mulligan guides. So yeah, wait, PC Kalen Aether Vial was Lurus. Not sure that's something I've seen before. Let's get basic forest maybe? Just to preserve my life total. Is it just a spirits? Spirits was Lurus, maybe? Maiden, they don't even play white and black mana. It's Merfolk. And you just was Lurus and play was Vio. Alright, dismember. A Lantern main deck. Okay. Fetch. What is going on? They just drew their few utility cards. This is someone who's usually at the top of the trophy leaderboards, or they've been in the past, I think. Alright, I need something that makes blue mana. I'll just cash it in, bounce Aether Vial. This is barely. Oh, I say it is Merfolk that just doesn't play anything cost more than two, so they have lures that they can put in play with Vial. Cool. This game's looking pretty grim. I need a Dryad, some kind of ramp. You guys draw my one Verdict too. That'd be cool. Multiple Solgad Lanterns in the main deck. Huh, okay, they have a few ways to cast Lurrus. Alright. Does playing Scapeshift do anything for me? Doesn't ramp you up, right, to have multiple Flagstone? No. I guess I'll cycle main phase in case I draw a Reclaimer. Teferi. How's my color mana requirement? I could play Bajukabok now in case I don't bring to light. Could that backfire? I'll play it now. It's all my Outer Lands potentially coming to play untapped. They have a two turn clock if they have black mana. Alright, I need Burning to Light, I think, exactly. Blue, white, black, green, red, okay. So, what are my options? Omnath, not good enough. Valky, not good enough. Verdict, buys me a decent bit of time. Think about Verdict, it's only four, so also don't have to take damage from my lands. Just get Rogrin, I guess. I'm not missing anything, right? Anything obvious? I need to get Verdict. Dryad? Does Dryad do anything for me? No. Alright, well, Verdict being very relevant, I guess. I was wondering if you really needed it. Definitely was good here. Wait, no attack was Mutavault. Weird. I guess they could have mana leaks, so I will play that first. I wonder why they didn't attack with mana vault. They have like Deprive? What else could they have? Because if they have Trickster, they can put it into play, so Must mean they have a 2-mana instant spell. Not sure what it could be. Okay, it is Deprive. It's gonna be close. Wait, they had that in hand? Where'd that come from? They had no cards. Do they have lethal? They don't, they have 7. Oh, they drew another counter spell? Oh wow. Oh, that sucks. I actually don't have double green yet. So I guess I said I should fetch. Oh wow. Lucky, lucky. I really did draw like double deprive too. Hopefully I have enough mountains left. Assuming I do. Valakut, Stomping Ground, Steam Vent, Triome. Isn't that 7? I'd like to pay 2 life, no. No. Sure. Nice. Yes. Sure, there's faster ways to do that. All right. Let's see. Veil seems amazing. Anger of the Gods seems amazing. Remian actually saved me here, but doesn't seem that great. I could do Madcap and Platinum too. They have Trickster to get through it, but seems kind of good. What else could I board out? Just trim Teferi. I could trim some of the expensive cards. Just trim Escape Shift. Since they don't have discard spells, just counter spells, and I have Veil now to protect it. It's possible you want all the Teferi and more Remands. Maybe even Rip Apart and Vanishing Verse, just Usually when you're playing 31 lands, though, you don't want too many one-for-one removal spells. Especially if they're not efficient. No green mana. Do have turn two Valky. I do have a nice hand if I do draw green mana. I have a lot of green sources. I could keep that. I don't think I hate it. I'll try it. I think turn two Valky and then Dryad plus Veil. I have to bring two light up some lands. Maybe I can do much better though. Keep for science. Deprive, force of negation. Or other way around, double deprive. Well, if they don't draw on tap blue and I draw green, I just win. So that's nice. All right, untap green for the win. No, tapped green. Dang. Don't want to trade for Mutavault? I don't think so. So we have Deprive Force plus one right now. Should I play Madcap plus Veil? Or Dryad plus Veil? Maybe bait was Madcap. Before I draw my Planium Empyrean. Be fine if I drew it up the Veil. They're having none of it. They're down to no cards though, one land. And just bring to light for Valky next turn maybe. Or I could try it first. I just want to block Lurrus. They block Lurrus, they get Lords, to put it in play. I don't think I should block. Chalice for one, okay. We'll just play double Dryad and Bring to Light next turn. I can play Bring to Light for Tybalt. Can I protect it for sure or not? Bring to Light for Tybalt seems... Let's say they draw black mana. Nope, let's say they draw Lords. Not that scary either. Alright. I think this is better. While they have no cards in hand. Oh. I have Tybalt in play. Right. Awkward. Alright, I'll just get on Omnath, I guess. Good enough. Oh, I'm sure you guys are having a good laugh right now. I mean, I could get Scapeshift too. I'm kind of lost now. I definitely don't want to get Reclaimer, I guess, because I have Chaos for one. Alright, let's just get on Omnath. Well, that was a pretty big mistake. I can see, can you imagine people going nuts in front of their screen being like, Gap, no, don't do it. You have Valky in hand. All right, so I definitely should have played both Dryads, said go, and then gone for the kill next turn. Oh well. Punts are real. But we get bailed out, so that's cool. That's still pretty far ahead. Seems pretty hard to lose now. Every draw step is good. Every draw step except for one mana spells. So far, so good. Just cruising. All right. All right, 3-0, nice, nice, nice. Nice, nice, nice. Of course, video is brought to you by Ultimate Guard. Great way to support the content is to shop with Ultimate Guard. You're helping us out and they have amazing products, whether it's their sleeves, their katana sleeves, their bag boxes. I never talk about it, but they also have backpacks. They have some pretty cool backpacks designed to like be pretty safe, you know, all the pockets are kind of like in the inside, so people can't really mess with your backpack if you're like, I don't know, in transports or in the subway, stuck with a billion people, or even at magic tournaments. just great line of product. They're always coming out with new stuff. They have a line of deck boxes coming out this summer made of almost all renewable materials, 97% renewable materials. And yeah, they're always innovating and trying to bring you the best quality of product. So definitely check them out if you need deck boxes or sleeves or whatnot. All right, let's see, no companion. That's always nice. Yeah, I guess I'll keep. My hand's got a little something going on. What land should I play on turn one, though? Maybe just try them. Just not be too greedy. I see I could draw a billion lands and want to cycle it, but control here is solid. Flooded Strand. I don't want a cleansing wildfire or anything, right? Save it for later. All right, is that Esper? Matchup where I actually have to think. All right, looks like Esper control. Should be tough. All the charms, the counters. The good removal. So let's see. If I Dryad, they can't really push it, so they probably have to counter it. Yeah, I think I'm gonna lead with Dryad here. Let's try that. Now I'm gonna play Temple Garden so that I have Omnath mana next turn. Not exactly clear if I was supposed to bait with Wildfire and then Dryad or other way around. If I can make the game last long enough, I might get to natural Velikit. I already have three mountains potentially. And I think I want to try and keep Omnath for the turn day if they ever want to tap out for a Jace or a Teferi. Try and punish them. Alright, so I could bug now. This way if they have Snapcaster, it kind of maybe forces their hand. Snapcaster up's not super scary though. I think maybe I'll just cycle main phase first and then play a steam vents. I'm gonna save bug for when they have a charm in the yard, I think. Could also play the fetch land to have it in play in case my Omnath ever resolves. seems unlikely, but there could be a spot where if you have two fetch lands in play and you resolve a Numnaf, if you go land plus double fetch, and you get to get the third ability and maybe nuke some planeswalkers. Alright, so I think this is a good spot to play the Jukabug. If they want to snap charm, they have to do it now. Tap out. Don't want to play Omnath into a Cryptic? Probably not. They have six cards. Another thing I have to keep in mind is Esper Charm making me discard. Which could be coming here. They have Snap, they could go for like make me discard two, untap Snap Charm. Down for the draw. So maybe that's a reason to play my cards before I lose them to a bunch of Esper Charms. This game is not going well. That's a solid opener. Mini Reclaimer is just gonna die to Fatal Push. Is there a sequence? Playing Reclaimer seems so bad. Maybe let them get to 8 cards in hand and they start discarding Fatal Push to hand size. At least try and tax their mana in some ways. Also just keeping the card to discard to Esper Charm. Feels like they gotta have a Fatal Push in hand at this point. They've seen so many cards. You could argue that the longer I wait, the worse the Reclaimer gets. But it is Esper Charm fodder, so. One, two, three, four, five, four. Getting kind of close. I think I should play a Flagstone. Start getting close to that mountain count. Can't imagine I'm winning this game. Seems like it should be pretty trivial for them to win. Fatal Push? Hey, got him. I could play one. I could play the Reclaimer. I'll just say go again. Yeah. Yeah. Reclaimer and Overrun Tomb, I guess. Alright, I need to get lucky. In hindsight, I wish I hadn't cycled Triome. Because the way the game was going, it felt like my best route to victory was just natural Valakut. I was thinking, oh, I'll just draw more mountains and maybe I can get something going. But maybe I should have realized as soon as turn 3 or 4 that that was the way I was going to be able to win this game. Not necessarily super intuitive without having played the matchups, you know, I mean, in almost every spot when you have a bunch of lands, you just want to cycle your cycling land. Sure. Yeah, I mean, if I had Rogrin Triumph in play right now, I'd be just one mountain off, right? Now I need to get super lucky. Okay, they're down to two lands. Probably they probably have field push, but I mean it's not getting any better, so I should just go for it. They could not have fatal push, they opted a bunch. You know, I'm assuming fatal push is not top on the list of cards they kept. Add the one eliminate, okay. Alright, they bottomed. I'm surely under 1% to win this game. I mean, they can start bouncing lands with Cryptic Command too. To make sure I can't even get lucky, yeah. Alright, Veil of Summer, yes please. What's bad against them? Nothing's super bad against them though. What are they gonna have? Let's see. Refresh my memory. You know, like maybe Mentor, maybe Dispute, maybe Gust. Word out the verdict, obviously. Onward Ego doesn't seem very good. It's like a bad discard spell. Volt is fine, I guess. May you guys blessing just a cantrip. I'll just keep one Volt. Keep hope they don't have turn on fail push. Alright, pretty good spots. Reclaimer can just be free wins in these matchups. Uncheck Reclaimer. I don't really want to expose my Reclaimer to a charm or anything. So I'm not sure what I want to do here. It's kind of obvious to have Veil when I play like that though, but I think it's probably still fine. I mean, now obviously gonna have a counter spell if I Veil, but I think that's fine if I make them tap out on their turn. Cause then I can go Dryad. Fetch, cleansing wildfire, my flagstone. I think that puts me in a reasonable spot. I could get super greedy and get Valakut, and if I draw a land, I just kill them? So if I get Valakut, I go Dryad, and if I draw land, I go land, deal 9. I think it's just too greedy, right? I don't think I need to. I mean, I think I'm still in, I mean, that might still be lethal, right? Yeah, I think that's still lethal. Get any land. Oh no, I guess it could have force of negation. Oh, never mind, it's lethal just. The fetch lands are lethal. I don't even need cleansing wildfire. Alright. Same deal. Alright, solid hand. Somehow I've muted and unmuted myself many, many times and still haven't forgotten to unmute. Very impressive. All right, let's see. Could just bait was a reclaimer, just make them have a counter spell. Pretty bottlenecked on green mana. Just gonna play a reclaimer. Drive's not always a must counter, but was all these Valakuts, they're gonna be pretty threatening. I'm just gonna jam one here. Even better, I drew the green source. Question is if I veil here, if they have fail push, or do I save my veil for a spot where they might not have a counter spell back up? Well, now I'm definitely veiling. Flusterstorm? Oh, Path to Exile. Alright. What was that? Just a basic mountain, right? Alright, this is going pretty well. Just naturally ramping to, I already have 4 or 5 mountains. Oh, tough spot. I wasn't paying attention. I guess he played a fetch land. Should I just cantrip here? All right, it means they can't cryptic command my spell either. That's pretty good. I think in that Man League, they might have Man League the Dryad earlier. But I could just chill. I think chilling and letting them play a charm would probably be a mistake though. So I'm not gonna chill. I've got no chill. I'm going to Stomping Ground. That was a cool use of Clanting Wildfire. Wow. So, if I play Valakut, it's high upside, but if it have removal, I get no damage. If I play Misty, I actually get a Bolt in. But who cares? I don't think it makes that big of a difference. Ah, destroy target enchantment. Nice. Alright, I've played lands, right? No. Should I just go for it? It's pretty bad if they have cryptic. It's really good if they don't have cryptic. I think I should maybe just go for it. Oh man, it's such a tough spot. Maybe I don't go for it just because I have Valakut and up to 5 mountains already. I'm just gonna say go. It's close. If they have Snapcaster draw 2, then probably made a mistake. It's tough. It looks like it worked out. Obviously, you could just have 2 lands in hand or something, and I'm just throwing the game, but if they have 2 lands in hand, I'm probably in a decent spot anyways. Alright, well, since I didn't have anything last turn, now I think you definitely want to keep saying go. Please play around Mana Leak. Shouldn't be a big deal. I can just one-shot it next turn. Alright, they don't have Cryptic Command mana up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, Teferi plus. Let's see. Sideboard games have felt decent. I think game one's probably a bit tough. Because you have targets for their fatal push and their eliminates. You have a few dead cards. It's kind of hard to get to six mountains. You need to get a little lucky with your land draws. Alright, well, that makes it easy. I mean, I guess I can do that first. I have still a lot of mountains left, right? I'm just going to do two. I don't think I need to do more, and I'm not exactly sure how many mountains I have left. Looks like I had a lot. Alright. Alright, nice. Playing for a trophy. It's almost like when I play good decks. It works. I've been playing mostly not good decks in Modern recently. Just when I play Modern, I just try and play something I enjoy and not necessarily like the tier 1 decks, but it's kind of nice to win with good decks too. Of course, if you like the content, feel free to give us a like, subscribe to the channel, and check out Channel Fireball for more content. Any purchase you make too, if you ever want to buy cards, you can do that on Channel Fireball. They're also starting a marketplace. So things are getting better and better. Just more options for all of you. And anytime you purchase cards from Channel Fireball or other products, you can use the code YellowHat. That supports me directly. I get a commission on every sale that's made with the code YellowHat. So if you want to support me in particular, you can do that. I also have a stream. If you know, you mostly watch my videos on YouTube, know that I stream pretty much every day, twitch.tv/YellowHat. Mostly Arena, not as much Modern because of the MPL implications. Most of our MPL tournaments are, or all of them are on Arena right now, and it's standard and historic, so that's why they usually play. Alright, we got our match right away last time. This time, a longer queue trying to find me an opening that's 3-0 or 4-0. Well, runny nose too. I was wondering if it was maybe my niece and my nephew I was taking care of them over the weekend. Maybe they gave me a little something. I don't feel too bad. I don't have a fever or anything, but, you know, all little puffy eyes, little throat ache. Oof. No companion. I have no idea if I'm supposed to keep that hand or not. Looks kind of bad, but also if I just draw a Dryad or a Reclaimer or a Teferi, then all of a sudden it feels like a pretty decent draw. As I said, I'm not sure these decks mulligan very well. Fairy Time Rattler would be a pretty card, pretty good card against my hand. All right, I'm just gonna jam. Just getting the land, even if that Fatal Push or Eliminate, just getting the one land into play is a pretty big deal. I can start jamming Bring to Lights before they have Cryptic Command mana up. Yeah. All right, looks like Esper is doing well today. He got paired against Esper at 3-0 and 4-0. Huh. Not too sure, honestly. Let's make sure we get Mountain. Stomping Ground. I think maybe Bring to Light because it's cheaper. Bring to Light because it's more mana efficient, is what I meant. Resolves? I did not expect resolves. Alright, I think I just get Vault here, right? I mean, Tibalt. I mean, they're just going to counter the Tibalt. That would have made sense, actually. People usually just counter to Bring to Light, I feel. All right, great hits. Hard to get bad hits, I guess. Feels like this game's over. Always have something really weird. Planeswalker removal. But the damage done, I mean, a free drawn into lock, a free land. Yeah. Alright. Sometimes they don't have it. It's one of the reasons why I like Archmage Charm over Esper Charm. There's that spot where you need the counter on turn 3 and only have an Esper Charm. I mean, Esper Charm is fine in complement, but I think I would play 4 Archmage Charm. Alright, same deal, I guess. Gonna keep in a 1 bolt. Keeping all the mass counters, right? Tack, tack, tack. Yeah. All right, one game away from a trophy. Cool stuff. Decks felt good. I would still like to know. I'll ask my stream this afternoon, my viewers. People will probably know what's up with them. Yeah, I mean, I guess you keep 31 lands, right? What's up with some of the sideboard cards? Definitely go for it here. Descry to the bottom. And they don't appear to have a removal spell, so that's pretty nice. They might be able to steal it, though. So if I get a land, does it do anything for me? Not really. Keeping Reman is nice though. Makes it so that I can't tap out for a Planeswalker. I can also use Reman on my own spells. Ganon, a Flagstone in play. I kind of want to just use Reman, honestly. I don't like their play of not eliminating on their turn. Because what if I have Flagstone? They just get blown out, and they're actually going to getting super punished here. I mean, I guess they're scared of me resolving something good, but there's not that much at cost 2 mana that I can have. And they play into Veil of Summer, and, you know. Alright, let's get Survive Black Mana. And then Basic, I think. Oh no, that was the Mount. That was a plain spark, and now I get any land I want. So I probably want a Valakut, right? Or another Flagstone. Just secure the Valakut. Alright. I don't hate just jamming, jamming a Bring to Light down their throat. Just make them, keep them busy. Not let them draw too. Well, unfortunately for me, I don't have, could just get a Dryad. Omnath's a bit more tempting, though. I might get countered anyways. I'll get Omnath, but I'm not sure that's correct. Alright. That's a good play by them. One less threat in my deck. Pretty unlikely to have an uncounterable spell. So do I go Teferi Dryad or Dryad Teferi? Need Dryad Teferi. All right. Don't want to fetch just for the free damage, or don't want to save it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I should save it for a potential chase. I'm going to go for Teferi. Dev Man Leak's not the end of the world, means they don't get to charm, etc. Alright, getting Teferi disputed there kind of feels bad, not going to lie. I they're in a tough spot though. They need to deal with Dryad. I have like natural Velikit Mountains. I have two Musk counters in hand. It's gonna play Flagstone first. Damage in. Attack for two. I don't even need to do anything, right? I'll just be playing into a Cryptic Command if I do. It's like I played into a Cryptic Command and also I'll let them draw two with a charm. If I don't do anything in that Cryptic Command, they're gonna bounce my Dryad and maybe counter it. Kinda wanna play the Scape Shift. Make them have Cryptic. They have Snap Eliminate. Yeah, I like playing. I think I like playing the Scape Shift here. Even if it does run into Cryptic. I think it's a bit different spot from last match where they had only two cards in hand. All right, Dovin's Veto. That's good. Kind of best case scenario, I want to say. Realistic best case scenario. All right. I mean, they're just dead if it don't do anything. We just got them in Devise. All right, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's not gonna work. Wait, it does work? Why did it take damage? Oh, because I still have... No. Oh, I have five other mountains still. Yeah, okay. Alright, so I guess I win. Because if they counter, they go down to three, and then I can just bolt them. All right, nice. Little dab, trophy. Well, that was very nice. I'm guessing the sideboard might need a little work, but I could be wrong. The mana base looked good. You got your basics. They're playing as many mountains as they can. I mean, I guess the next step would be trying to see if you really do need Temple Garden, Breeding Pool, etc., but I'm guessing you do. Maybe Overgrown Tomb can go. Especially if you get rid of some of the black cards in the sideboard, but yeah, deck was good. As usual, I hope you enjoyed the video. And, you know, tons of ways to support the content. Ultimate Guard, channelfireball.com. Give us a like, give us a subscribe. And yeah, hope everyone has a great week. And I'll see you next time. Take care.